Okay, now let's start working on some real code here. We're going to do an extended example. This is going to reflect what you'll be doing in your homework for this unit quite closely. So we're going to be using the Google App Engine Datastore. And this is the database provided by App Engine that is actually pretty cool to use. So a couple things that are worth pointing out. What we've been referring to as tables are known as entities in the Google App Engine data store. They serve basically the same purpose, which is how you organize things of the same data type together. You know, instead of having a table for links, you'd have an entity called link, and then you'd have, you know, a bunch of links. A couple things about entities. The columns are not fixed. That is, in a table, you had to have a fixed number of columns that you define when you define the table. And in a Google App Engine entity, you can have whatever columns you want. Even entities of the same type don't have to have the same columns. This makes development actually a lot easier. When you're working with tables, often, you know, you build your table and you add a feature, and then you realize, oh, you know, I needed this column. And then you have to add that column. And sometimes adding a column to a database with, you know, millions of rows can be quite troublesome. In Google, we don't have that problem. You know, you can have whatever columns you want. You can actually change the columns while you're developing. It's very handy. Entities all have an ID. And this ID can either be assigned automatically by the data store, which is what we'll do in most cases, or you can make up your own ID. So if you want to use integers or if you want to use strings, you can use whatever you want. But every entity has an ID field. And another important thing that will be a factor going forward is that entities have this notion of parents and ancestors. And this is a relationship to other entities that has a couple of very specific use cases. So to keep going with our link example, if we had an entity called a link, it might have a parent that is, you know, Reddit. And then we can do queries to say, you know, get me all of the links that are a child of Reddit. And this has some interesting notions with regard to consistency in the App Engine database. So it's not something we need to understand deeply. And to be honest, I'm just learning how to use the data store myself. So I am by no means an expert in how the data store works. But something that's important is that if you give your entities a parent, you can get around some limitations on consistency, which is one of the things I'll talk about.